Students, this is 9th standard science class and the chapter we are dealing with is motion lesson. I am Yashoda talking to you all. Children, today in this session let us try to know the graphical representation of motion. Children, when we say graphical representation, it is something related to graphs, lines, axes, vertical lines, horizontal lines and all this. You must have observed, children, when the cricket match will be going on, there will be some vertical bar graphs. There will be vertical bar graphs to represent or to show the run rate of a team in each over. In every over, how the cricketer, the player will score the run, to show that there will be a vertical bar graph. And that bar graph, which is actually called, which will be in the straight line, will tell us in each over how many runs, what is the rate of the run rate and all these things. To describe, and if we have to know the motion of an object, can these graphs be used? That means the line graphs, will they help us to know the movement of the objects? When the object is moving, there are so many physical quantities like velocity, that means speed, distance covered, time taken and all these things. So with all this information, is it possible that we can understand with the help of the graph? That is what we will be knowing in this session, children. Children, if you look into this graph, this is actually distance, time, graph of an object which is moving in a uniform speed, children. That means here is the position of the object, and this line, that means it is the x axis and this is the y axis. The x axis is telling us the time taken by the object, and the y axis will tell us the kilometers it is covered. And if you observe this, we can know that at what interval, what is the kilometer covered by an object. So this is one type of graph which we call it as distance time graph, because we know the time here and we have the distance covered there. And it is a uniform speed. Now, how can we say it is a uniform speed, children? Now, you just look into the intervals of these timings. Here is a gap of 20 minutes, another 20 minutes, and another 20 minutes. 0 to 20 minutes, the object has moved 10 kilometers. And 20 to 40, that means another 20 minutes, it is 20 kilometers. Like this, if you look into these points, you get a straight line. That means this straight line in the graph tells us that the object is moving in a uniform speed. So this graph line represents the movement, what type of movement the object is actually going on. So it is a uniform motion. So that is one part, children. The object is moving in the uniform speed. With this, we can also notice that the time taken by the object is directly related to the distance covered. The distance traveled by an object is directly related to the time taken. In place of directly related, children, we can use a word proportional to. 20 minutes gap, 10 minutes of 10 kilometers of distance covered. So distance traveled by an object is directly proportional to the time taken. So this graph also tells us the relationship and what the dependency of the time and the distance covered, how they are related. That also this will tell. Not only that, this particular graph, that means distance time graph, also tells that if you observe here, children, this is O and this is B, this is the straight line. So this straight line tells us that every 20 minutes there is an increase in the distance covered also. The portion OB of the graph shows that the distance is increasing. One point is that. Another point is it is increasing uniformly. That means there is a uniform rate of increase of distance at every uniform interval. That means the speed of the vehicle is also uniform. That means velocity. Velocity of the object is also uniform. So uniform velocity, uniform speed. And naturally, the magnitude of the displacement of an object will be equal to the distance traveled by the object along with y-axis. The time taken and the distance covered will be proportional. It also tells us O and B, which is a straight line, tells us that there is an increase in the distance covered by an object, and that increase is actually uniform increase in the distance covered. So this is what the graphs of motion related to, irrespective of the aspects, children, it can be distance and time, it can be distance and speed and all these things. In the coming classes, let us try to know another type of graphs, children. Thank you.